Premature ejaculation is one of the most frustrating experiences a man can have in his sex life. And so many guys are confused about exactly why it's happening to them and what the causes of this condition are. So in today's video, I'm gonna go through all the science behind premature ejaculation and specifically the brain chemistry that is going on and the chemicals in your brain that are dictating whether or not you have premature ejaculation or not. Emotions like anxiety, guilt, stress, depression, these all are psychological causes of premature ejaculation. But these external emotions are all related to hormones and neurotransmitters in your brain. Like, these two things go hand in hand, you know, the emotion and the hormone. And fun fact, there's actually a strong link between premature ejaculation and performance anxiety. So in this video, I'm gonna go over a bunch of the hormones and neurotransmitters that influence premature ejaculation. Let's start with testosterone. Men with low testosterone who were given testosterone therapy lasted 4.8 times longer than they had done previously, while men given the most common on-demand SSRI, Dopamine, lasted only 1.8 times longer. Moving on, oxytocin. Oxytocin participates in ejaculation by enhancing sensitivity and involuntary contractions. Men with premature ejaculation have higher levels of oxytocin than those without premature ejaculation. And oxytocin antagonists have been shown to delay ejaculation. However, that's not necessarily a good strategy, and we'll get into that. Dopamine. Dopamine is a catecholamine that, together with oxytocin, can promote premature ejaculation. Dopamine agonists are commonly used to treat delayed ejaculation. Certain dopaminergic compounds such as Ritalin can contribute to spontaneous ejaculation. Now, we shouldn't paint dopamine as the bad guy here, because it's really not. And dopamine is extremely important for libido and pleasurable orgasms. Noradrenaline and adrenaline. Now, these are also catecholamines. They are part of the sympathetic nervous system. And our overstimulation of the sympathetic nervous system promotes ejaculation. People that are typically overstimulated struggle with sleep, they struggle with anxiety, premature ejaculation, erectile dysfunction, a whole host of other things. Nitric oxide. Now, nitric oxide, you know, technically isn't a hormone or a neurotransmitter, it's just a gaseous signaling molecule. But nitric oxide not only helps with erections, but it can help to delay ejaculation as well. This might be one of the reasons why men with ED, erectile dysfunction, tend to also have premature ejaculation. Glutamate. Glutamate is an excitatory neurotransmitter. It helps a lot with mood, focus, libido, and even testosterone production. However, too much can become toxic to the brain and contribute to premature ejaculation. Human studies found that men with lifelong premature ejaculation have remarkably increased glutamate activity in the thalamus of the brain. GABA. GABA is our main inhibitory neurotransmitter. GABA plays an important role in premature ejaculation by reducing excess dopamine, noradrenaline, serotonin, and glutamate firing. So it does a whole lot for us in a positive way. In rat studies, rats with premature ejaculation had lower expression and distribution of both GABA-A and GABA-B receptors compared to normal rats. Serotonin and SSRI meds. Now, medications known as selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, SSRIs, these work by delaying the ejaculation reflex signal to the brain via the sympathetic nervous system, which then influences the amount of serotonin that reaches the brain. By doing this, the breakdown of serotonin in the body is inhibited, so levels remain higher than normal, and this prevents early ejaculation. But here's the problem. Treatment with SSRIs is associated with a host of side effects, things like fatigue, drowsiness, hypertension, nausea, dizziness, anxiety, vomiting, diarrhea, dry mouth, excessive perspiration, effects which cause a very high dropout rate when people are prescribed SSRIs to treat premature ejaculation. SSRIs are a terrible route to take. Let's talk about depression for a second, because we were talking about serotonin and SSRIs a minute ago. What everyone has been regurgitating for the last couple of decades is that serotonin is the happy hormone, the feel-good hormone. Serotonin is low in depressed people. Research is showing that it's not the boost in serotonin that's beneficial, because the SSRI drugs only become effective in treating depression after a few weeks, which casts doubt on if serotonin is really the missing link here. The main hypothesis for why SSRI drugs only start to work after a few weeks is because increased neurosteroids in the brain, such as allopregnanolone, that has pro-GABA effects. And it's actually the GABA that has the antidepressant properties. It takes a while for the SSRI drug to increase allopregnanolone, and when it gets high enough, that antidepressant effect kicks in. Desensitizing sprays. Let's quickly talk about desensitizing sprays because people always throw this up whenever you talk about premature ejaculation. They contain active ingredients like lidocaine, which is basically a local anesthetic. Basically tries to treat premature ejaculation by completely removing any sensation in the penis whatsoever. Basically taking away all the enjoyment out of it. The problem is this shit rubs off onto your woman while you're having sex with her. And now her clitoris is completely numb and she can't enjoy herself either. Congratulations, you're both having terrible sex now. Well done. Now, I've thrown a lot of big words and science at you today, so let's try and summarize all this. Testosterone, serotonin, nitric oxide, and GABA can help to delay your ejaculation. Noradrenaline, adrenaline, estrogen, oxytocin, and glutamate promote ejaculation. Many things that reduce premature ejaculation are undesirable, like reducing oxytocin or dopamine or increasing serotonin. The conclusion that I have come to is that the single best neurotransmitter for you to target is actually GABA. You want to increase GABA, and that will not only calm you down, it'll also help to reduce some of these excitatory chemicals, which causes you to prematurely ejaculate. Now, the really exciting thing for you guys is that through all my research into this, I have formulated a supplement to treat premature ejaculation through this exact pathway. It is called Stud. It is the brand new supplement from my Clubhouse line of supplements. You can check it out in the link in the description. Stud is designed to help you get over premature ejaculation to last as long as you want in the bedroom, specifically by increasing GABA, reducing things like glutamate, adrenaline, noradrenaline, cortisol in your body through correct and accurate supplementation. It's very exciting. We've only got a limited number of bottles. It launches today, so get your hands on some. There's a link in the description down below.